Well, it was a real thrill, like last year when we went to Stanley Kamikaze. Regina Carpinelli came up to me and she invited me personally, you know, on behalf of Stan to come to Stanley's Kamikaze. I was like, oh, that's really cool. You know, that was the kind of I've made it sort of moment. And you have a lot of those throughout your life when you do stuff like this, and you got to, you know, count each and every one as a you know, big blessing. Hello, I'm Dawn Best. I'm artist for Archie Comics, Sonic the Hedgehog series, as well as founder of Glory Hound Network, and we're hanging out here at the Cleveland Comic Con. What I'm doing right now is a series called Sylvana, and Sylvana was kickstarted this past year. It's myself drawing, editing, doing basically everything except the script writing, which is handled by Ian Flynn, writer extraordinaire for Sonic the Hedgehog, for the New Crusaders, for Mega Man X, everything basically in the whole Archie Comics action roundup at this point. I knew when time came to go to college that I wanted to get something art related. I was really stellar at it. I was that kid at school, you know. And I had no reason not to, so went to art school, went for graphic design, however. And I only went for a 2-year degree, which was important to me because I got accepted to a lot of classes. I got accepted to a lot of 4-year degrees, but A, the expense, B, the amount of stuff that wasn't art related, I wasn't as into. And it's been my mission kind of to teach artists as well that if you're good at this, you don't necessarily need college, but it does help, you know, a little bit. So I do have a bit of a background in that. Mostly I'm self-taught when it comes to the illustration stuff. And I actually got my first job at Archie before I graduated college, when Ken Pender sent out, you know, an APB to, you know, get some help on a script. I submitted my stuff. He said, come on board. And it worked out. It was really rare, though. I mean, it's not like you just have that happen any day of the week. You know, I was 19 years old and, wow, you know, suddenly I'm working for this company. Most of the time, when you are showing a portfolio and you think that you're a really good artist and you're ready to break into comics, you're missing little things, like really big things that are really little. I see a lot of portfolios where there's actually no comic work in it. That's just pinups and stuff. And that's one of the first things that people don't do correctly. And it's easy. I mean, honestly, but it's strange because a lot of people miss that. So draw comics. Draw comics every day if you can, and make your own stories if you can. You will find no better practice for drawing whatever you want to draw, whatever it might be, than to write a story about it. I don't care if it's a fan fiction, I don't care if it's an official thing, I don't care if it's your own idea, I don't care if it's somebody else's idea, but if you find the time to draw the comics, you will only improve because you have to know how to draw everything when you're doing a comic book, and it's the best way to show you how to do that. Also, study movies, study, you know, direction, study things like that and see how things come together. Study story, pacing, and other elements like that. The other big thing I would say, if you want to be a colorist, work on your color. If you want to be a penciler, work on your pencils. If you want to be an inker, work on your ink. Dabble, yes, but pinpoint one thing that you want to really do and really nail it, really go after it. I think a lot of people diversify a little bit too much, and it's great to be diverse. It's great to, you know, have a ton of skills, but editors want to see what you do with pencils if you're going to be a penciler for them, and they want to see something that'll knock them off their socks instead of, here's some pencils, but also I color. Check out my colors. You know, they're nice, but we're looking for a really dynamite penciler, is what most people say. We'll